Lighting is critical to producing high quality productions. If you're shooting your videos using only ambient lighting in most corporate offices or homes, you're leaving lots of quality on the table. You don't have to spend a fortune to get good lighting, but you do need to buy smart and know what you're getting. Hang on to the end because I'm going to discuss in detail four different types of bulbs available for your videos, films, and photos. Hi, I'm Jim Costa. I'm a videography, photography, and technology guru, but you can call me a dadographer. I've created many other videos on improving your photography, videography, filmmaking, video editing, audio recording, and technology skills. And I'll link to those in the description below and both during and at the end of this video as well, so stay tuned. If you want to learn more, remember to subscribe to my channel and hit that bell to be notified when I upload new videos. I upload every week, and I'll be uploading many more explanations of film, video, photo editing, and tech topics. Stay tuned to the end to find out how to get my free DSLR mirrorless or interchangeable lens video camera cheat sheet that'll have you shooting your photos and videos like a pro in no time. Best of all, my cheat sheet specializes in shooting video with any type of camera, including mirrorless and DSLR cameras. In it, you'll find all the info you need on important video techniques, such as white balance, color temperature, frame rates, and more. The info I've assembled for you will definitely help to improve your work. I am a full-time working photographer, video producer, editor, and technology pro. That's the small business that I own, and it's how I make a living. You'll find my contact info in the description below. Contact me if you need photography or video production for you personally, for your business, or for someone you know. Number one are tungsten lights, or sometimes known as quartz halogen lights. Tungsten lights are incandescent filament bulbs which are common in homes and offices but have been slowly replaced with longer lasting, more reliable, more energy efficient bulbs. What sets these bulbs apart is that they take advantage of what's known as the halogen cycle. Each bulb has pressurized halogen gas within them. The gas helps redeposit evaporated tungsten metal back on the filament, causing it to shine more brightly. Tungsten lamps operate at a high temperature and thus have a higher color temperature and are more luminous. Tungsten bulbs are often used to mimic daylight because they produce a warm light. They also are used to light interiors and match domestic spaces or office locations. They usually have open-faced light fixtures or are sometimes used in Fresnels. They can go up to 200 kilowatts and usually have a dimmer switch to help you control direct light. They produce a continuous spectrum of light from near ultraviolet to infrared, producing near perfect color rendition. If you want to change the color temperature of tungsten bulbs, you need to use gels. Some of the advantages of tungsten lights include almost perfect color rendition, low cost. It does not use mercury like CFLs or fluorescent lights or mercury vapor lights. They have better color temperature than standard tungsten. They have longer life than conventional incandescent bulbs. When turned on, they are instantly at full brightness. There's no warm-up time. It's also dimmable. Some disadvantages of tungsten lights include they get extremely hot, they have a high power requirement, the lamp is sensitive to oils and cannot be touched, the bulb is actually capable of blowing and sending hot shards outward, which can hurt you if you're standing in front of it. A screen or layer of glass on the outside of the lamp can help to protect someone using it. Number two are HMI lights. HMI stands for Hydrargyrum medium arc iodide, and that is a mouthful. HMI lights are metal halide gas discharge medium arc lamps. Yes, that is super technical, I get it. HMI lamps are capable of between 85 and 108 lumens per watt, up to four times that of conventional incandescent lamps. They're able to produce that high of an output thanks to a chemical reaction between mercury and electricity in the bulb. HMI bulbs are designed to emit a 6,000 color temperature light to match sunlight. HMI lights lamps are also flicker free. HMIs are used when high output is required. They are also used to recreate sun shining through windows or to fake additional sun while shooting exteriors. HMIs can light huge areas at once. They were traditionally used in movie theater projectors when projecting films on the big screen. The advantages of HMI lights: they have high light output, higher efficiency, and high color temperature. The disadvantages of HMI lights: they have a high cost, a high power requirement, and they dim only to about 50%. The color temperature does increase when you're dimming. HMI bulbs will explode if dropped and release toxic chemicals, the mercury inside. Number three are fluorescent lights. A fluorescent light contains low-pressure mercury vapor bouncing around to produce ultraviolet light. Fluorescent lights are more efficient than incandescent lights. They are capable of generating up to 100 lumens per watt, similar to the output of HMIs. So what's that mean? It means that the spectrum of light emitted can achieve a CRI up to 99. The color temperature of a fluorescent can vary from 2700 Kelvin to 6500 Kelvin. Fluorescent film lighting is achieved by layering multiple tubes next to each other, combining as many as you want for the desired brightness. The good news is you can choose your bulbs to either be warm or cool depending upon the scenario that you're shooting. You want to get these bulbs close to the subject because they're not great at opening up spaces. Fluorescent lighting is used to light interiors and is more compact than tungsten or HMI light. The advantages of fluorescent lights for your video and filmmaking are: they have high efficiency, low power requirements, low cost, long lamp life, they're relatively cool to the touch, they're capable of soft, even lighting over a large area, and they're lightweight. The disadvantages of fluorescent lights are: they flicker, they have a high CRI, domestic tubes have a low CRI, and poor color rendition. In case you're wondering, CRI stands for color rendering index. If you're not sure what color rendering index is, I've actually done a video on that subject, and I'll put a link to that in the description below for you. Number four are LED lights. LED stands for light emitting diode. LED lights are solid state semiconductor devices. LEDs are extremely efficient. They're truly the lights of the future, mostly because we keep inventing new ways to use them. Right now, they are limited in overall light output when compared to any of the other light sources, but things can change fast. LED lights can reflect daylight and many have a variable color temperature, so you can seamlessly switch color temperatures as needed. The CRI rating of LEDs can be over 90. LEDs are more and more common on film sets. You can use batteries to power them. That makes them portable and sleek. No messy cabling needed. You can rig your own panels of LED lights to fit any space necessary as well. LEDs can also power Fresnel-style lamp heads, such as by manufacturers such as Ari. The advantages of LEDs: they have soft, even lighting. They are pure light without UV artifacts. They have high efficiency, low power consumption, and can even be battery powered. They're excellent for dimming by means of pulse width modulation control. They have a long lifespan, they're environmentally friendly, they're insensitive to shock, and there's no risk of explosion. The disadvantages of LED lights: they have high cost. LEDs are currently still expensive for their total light output. Which light is best for you to use? Well, frankly, all of them. Each light we covered has a specific purpose, so it really depends on what you're trying to do on set, the lights that you have access to, and the nature of the scene and your story. My question of the day is, what is your favorite kind of light? Leave a comment below and let us know. Would you like to learn more about your camera settings to get you shooting like a pro? I've created an absolutely free cheat sheet for you on all the best camera settings to shoot video with your DSLR, mirrorless, or video camera. They'll show you the settings that will allow your photos and videos to shine and stand out from the competition. The link to get that cheat sheet is just below in the video description. I've also created cheat sheets on other topics such as video editing, and now even offer training courses on editing video using Adobe Premiere Pro, and soon I'll have others. I'll link to those cheat sheets and training courses below as well. Learn to edit like a pro with my training course. That I guarantee it. Do you want to see more videos like this? Follow my YouTube channel, jimcostafilms, for more. Think what you saw was great? Like it. Do you have an opinion? Comment below. You know someone who could benefit from the info I provided? Please share the video. Do you want to learn even more? If so, then connect with Jim Costa Films on social media and online on Facebook, Instagram, Twitter, YouTube, and the web. I currently have over 4,300 videos on my YouTube channel, Jim Costa Films, so feel free to check out many of my other videos for great tips and suggestions. If you've followed me for a while now, you may know that I have a community of photographers, videographers, and filmmakers, just like you, on Facebook, where I share other pro tips and tricks. It's called Video Producers and Content Creators. I love new members who want to share their work, learn from others, and also help others because of their own experience and talents. You'll find a link to that group in the description below. Feel free to join it, where you'll learn even more.